Hi viewers, welcome to our electrical engineering lecture channel for most interactive sessions of different subjects of electronic and electrical engineering. For the latest updates and videos, don't forget to subscribe and click the like button.
Given SI, which we are able to find. So just replacing these two and now rewriting the same expression, which was that if we are going to compare probability of MI given Z greater than probability of MK given Z for K not equal to I. So, right, this was the map detection rule. Now we can rewrite by using this above expression, that it can be written as probability of MI. Probability of MI, it is Z given MI to probability of MI divided by probability of Z greater than probability of Z given MK into probability of MK divided by probability of Z. So here it will be cancelled out, and you are going to compare the above thing, and that can be written as probability of Z given MI into probability of MI is greater than probability of Z given MK into probability of MK. So it becomes the rule, and again for the same K not equal to I, which means we have to compare this particular thing with all the right hand side expressions for all the values other than I. So if this left hand side is greater than the right hand side for all K not equal to I, then we will declare that the detected symbol M hat will be equal to MI. So in this way it will proceed. And again, if in this particular type of detection the priori probabilities which are MI and MK, so if I write here that if a priori probabilities probability of M1 equal to probability of M2 up to probability of MM, if they are equal, which means they are equal, then map will be reduced to maximum likelihood. So now the detector becomes detect MI if from the above expression probability of Z given MI is greater than probability of Z given MK, again for all K not equal to I. So just in this case you have to compare the likelihood functions of one for a particular value of I with all the other values, and simply you can say that if you have a total of m likelihood functions, this is the crux, that if you have a total of m likelihood functions, the one which is maximum of all, that will be declared as the detected symbol. So like if you have m likelihood functions and you say that in a particular case probability of Z given M2 is the maximum among all the likelihood functions, so in that case the detected symbol will be M2. If any other case, if the likelihood function probability of Z given M4 is the maximum among all the m likelihood functions, then you will declare that the received symbol or the detected symbol will be M4. So in this way the symbols are detected in case of multiple signals. So this is the same discussion that we have already covered. One more thing that I have missed, it is that in instead of comparing the likelihood functions directly, in some cases it is mathematically easier to compute and then compare the log likelihood functions. What is log likelihood functions? Here, if you see in the second box, this was the likelihood function inside the square brackets. If you take natural log of this, so overall this quantity becomes log likelihood function. So I will write here, it is log likelihood functions. So instead you compare the likelihood functions, because usually this likelihood function, the reason behind is that the likelihood function is in the form of exponential, because the Gaussian PDF is an exponential, is a kind of exponential PDF. Exponential, it contains exponential function rather in the expression for PDF. So when you take natural log and exponents will be cancelled out. So mathematically, it will be relatively easier to find and compare the log likelihood functions. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is that if you are performing either map detection or ML detection, you will divide the complete region, the complete space into M regions. So if you have like this, this is demonstrated for M is equal to 4. So if you have 4 signals to transmit, that is capital M is equal to 4. So you will divide the complete space into M regions. And by virtue of this thing, because this particular thing was appearing in the numerator of the exponent. So let me again explain to you that actually we are going to find out which likelihood function is maximum. So you see, if this particular thing for a particular likelihood function is minimum, it is coming in the argument of exponential with negative sign. So if this norm is minimum, it will increase the value of exponent, which means that the likelihood function will go towards maximum. So you can say that the likelihood function will be maximum if the argument of this exponential is minimum. And the argument of exponential minimum means z and si, these two vectors are not very far apart from each other. So we will be just calculating this Euclidean distance. That was the point that I have already explained in the starting lectures, that the basic purpose or basic motivation of representing these signals in the form of vectors is to calculate the Euclidean distance. So you see, after all that discussion, what is the conclusion? The conclusion is that if we have the received vector as z, the transmitted vectors as si, so we will be only comparing the Euclidean distance. If for a particular received vector, Euclidean distance of that received vector is minimum with, let's say, s2, then it means the corresponding likelihood function will be maximized. So let me write this conclusive point over here, that if z minus si norm is minimum for a particular si, then its corresponding log likelihood function will be maximum, which log likelihood function? This one, p of z given si. So this is the main point. So now we divide all the space into 4 regions, or generally speaking M regions. So this is the rule that we have already explained. Vector z lies inside region zi if z minus sk, or you can say the Euclidean distance between z and sk is minimum for all k is equal to I. So you have partitioned the region. Now you can see that we have transmitted 4 symbols, this s1, s2, s3 and s4. These are our 4 transmitted symbols. We divided the complete space into four regions. So this is the first region, Z1. This is the second region, Z2. This is the third region, Z3. And the fourth region, Z4. And this is a very intuitive approach to partition the space so that the regions of all the corresponding to all the four symbols become equivalent. Now, let's say if we receive a signal Z whose vector form can be plotted over here like this. So this is the received vector Z. Now, the basic thing will be, in order to select the maximum likelihood function. So in order to select the maximum likelihood function, instead of going towards that approach, the consequence of that approach was to find out the Euclidean distance, which comes in the power of the exponential. You just find the Euclidean distance between this received vector Z and all the vectors S1, S2, S3 and S4. So the vector with which the Euclidean distance of Z is minimum, it will be detected, it will be declared as the detected symbol. So in this particular case, it is very much clear that the Euclidean distance of Z with S2 is minimum, due to which the detected symbol S hat will be S2. Similarly, let's say in another case, if you receive the symbol over here like this, if this is Z for any particular case, then in this case, this distance between Z and S4, it is going to be minimum. So in that particular case, you will declare S hat is equal to S4. And this process goes on. So now at the end of this portion of lecture, we will be discussing a very, very important figure of merit, which is very specific to digital communications. As you all know, that in case of analog communication, the figure of merit is SNR, which is signal to noise ratio, signal power divided by noise power. But in case of digital communication system, because we are dealing in the form of bits and symbols, and signals are transmitted within a symbol duration, a particular symbol duration, so these type of signals will be treated as energy signals, which have zero power. So when these signals have zero power, we cannot be able to find SNR. So there must be some another figure of merit, and that figure of merit is EB over N0, this one, where this EB is the bit energy and N0 is the noise PSD. So if you represent this bit energy in the form of power, you can always say, because we all know that power is energy per unit, energy can be represented as in the form of this expression, power multiplied by time. So power is energy per unit time. So by using this expression, power multiplied by the duration of each bit, S into TB, and divided by in the denominator, because this is PSD, and PSD is basically power per unit hertz. So you can write it as noise power divided by its bandwidth. So its unit becomes power per unit hertz. So rearranging this expression, you can come up with this thing, which is basically the relationship between EB over N0 and SNR. This is the EB over N0. So the relationship says that if you multiply signal to noise ratio with this particular thing, W over RB, where W is the bandwidth and RB is the bit rate, if you multiply SNR with this ratio, that SNR will be converted into EB over N0. And remember, in digital communication, we always compare, we always find or we always check the probability of bit error corresponding to EB over N0, not SNR. Like this plot is showing. In this plot, we are comparing the performance of binary PAM with 4-array PAM. So this is a particular type of bit error rate plot which you will frequently encounter in case of digital communication system. Whenever we are going to compare two or more schemes with each other, we will just plot their bit error rate in the form of this waterfall curve. This is called waterfall curve because of its shape. On the x-axis we have EB over N0, and on the y-axis we have probability of bit error, or we can also plot probability of symbol error. Like in this case, we have symbol error probability. So on the x-axis, AB over N0 is increasing in this direction from 0 to 20. This is the axis which you can select at your own. And on the y-axis, it is logarithmic scale. Remember, if we need to have this waterfall curve, then we need to set the y-axis as logarithmic, on logarithmic scale. So now, binary PAM means we have capital M is equal to 2. 4-AD PAM means we have capital M is equal to 4. So from this plot, you can see that this one is for 4-AD and this blue one is for binary. Now, if we are going to check which scheme is better in terms of symbol error probability, how can you check? The answer is, we will see that the scheme which achieves a particular BER at lower SNR, that scheme will be better. This must be the rule, that I am repeating, the scheme which will attain a particular BER at lower value of SNR as compared to the other scheme, that will be declared as better. So let's say we fix that particular value of BER at 10 to the power minus 3. It can be fixed anywhere. And we draw a horizontal line like this. And see, now from the intersection point, we draw the vertical line like this. So I can roughly say that binary PAM is achieving the BER or the symbol error probability of 10 to the power minus 3 at almost, you can say, 7.5 dB. And the same symbol error probability is achieved by 4-AD PAM at almost 12 dB of EB over N0. So just comparing, it is very much clear that binary PAM is achieving the same symbol error probability at lower SNR, which means it will be better. So as a rule, now after having this point, you will not always draw these lines and then vertical lines to compare which scheme is better. It is much time consuming. If you see the basic rule of thumb, which comes out to be, it is that the scheme whose curve is goes towards y-axis, it is more close to the y-axis, it means that scheme will be better. So in this particular case, the blue curve, which is for binary, it is closer to y-axis as compared to the red one, or it is inside. So it means that the scheme will be better. So as a rule of thumb, you can say that if you have multiple waterfall curves and you have to compare the schemes, you will simply see that the scheme with waterfall curve more close to y-axis or that will be declared as the best scheme in terms of BER or in terms of symbol error probability. So that's all for today's lecture. Thank you very much for listening.